Let's talk about the physical properties of carboxylic acids. As we've looked at each of the families of organic compounds, one of the topics that always comes up is that of physical properties. And each time we're concerned primarily with boiling points, water solubility, and the impact of hydrogen bonding upon these two. Carboxylic acids, it turns out, have the highest boiling points of any of the families that we've talked about so far. Let's look at a table. We'll see in a minute that carboxylic acids are terrific at hydrogen bonding, and that puts them at the top of the list as far as boiling points. Hydrocarbons, ethers, tertiary amines, you'll recall that they don't hydrogen bond, so they're down here, they're the lowest boiling of all the families. Aldehydes and ketones, when they're in the pure form, they don't hydrogen bond. Amines, the primary and secondary amines, have an NH or more than one hydrogen, and so they're capable of hydrogen bonding. That moves them up a little on the scale for boiling points, because the more interactions we have in a sample, the more difficult it is for molecules to escape into the gaseous state, and so the higher the boiling point. Alcohol's pretty good at hydrogen bonding, so they're up here, and then at the top, carboxylic acids. Down here, I've shown two molecules of acetic acid, or ethanoic acid, and the blue lines represent the hydrogen bonding. Here's a molecule on this side, a molecule over here, and we see that carboxylic acids are very efficient in forming hydrogen bonding. There's a hydrogen positioned between two electronegative oxygens up here. Down here is a second way that hydrogen bonding can be involved. Again, a hydrogen positioned between the two oxygens. And the net effect of this kind of intermolecular hydrogen bonding is that it draws two molecules of carboxylic acid close together. It almost becomes one molecule, so effectively doubling the molecular weight. These are called dimers, and dimers have high boiling points. Let's look at the effect of water. Carboxylic acids have two oxygens, and so they're very efficient at hydrogen bonding with water. Two different ways. Here's a water molecule with its hydrogen being attracted to the electronegative oxygen of the carboxylic acid. So the blue line represents the hydrogen bond between water and the carboxylic acid. Down here, the hydrogen of the carboxylic acid is attracted to the neighboring oxygen of water. So again, a hydrogen positioned between two oxygens, bridging those two molecules, drawing the carboxylic acids into solution. So what we find is that carboxylic acids with five or fewer carbons are very soluble in water. If we were to lengthen that chain beyond five carbons, then the impact of the hydrocarbon nature of the carboxylic acid starts to outweigh the impact of the two oxygens, and so we find that they're insoluble in water. Let's look at a summary diagram. The water solubility chart for the family of organic compounds looks almost exactly like the one that we just looked at for boiling points. There's only one exception. We'll come to that in just a second. Carboxylic acids, hydrogen bond with water very efficiently there at the top. Alcohols are good, very soluble. Primary and secondary amines can hydrogen bond with water. Aldehydes and ketones can hydrogen bond with water, and so also can tertiary amines. And way down at the bottom, hydrocarbons, no hydrogen bonding with water here. And ethers, they can hydrogen bond with water, so ethers might be slightly above hydrocarbons. The difference in the two diagrams that we looked at, tertiary amines and boiling points was down here. But because tertiary amines can hydrogen bond, they've moved up a little bit in terms of water solubility.